Hello everyone. I am Payal Pridarshini, PGT Biotechnology, Kendriya Vidyalaya No. 3, Delhi Cant. In my last session, we learned about process of transcription in prokaryotes. Today, we learn about process of transcription in eukaryotes. Before going in detail, let's answer those questions which I asked in my last session. The first question was, what do you mean by transcription? Yes, transcription is the transfer of genetic information from DNA to RNA. Whatever genetic information is present in DNA is transferred to the RNA so that the RNA will transfer those information in the form of protein. Or we can say transcription is formation of RNA from DNA. So, I hope the answer will be clear to you. The next question is, write the RNA transcript for following DNA template, and the template is given from 3 prime to 5 prime. As in my last session I told you, the DNA is double stranded while RNA is single stranded. So, only one strand of the DNA is being transcribed to form single stranded RNA. As RNA and DNA both are synthesized in 5 prime to 3 prime direction. So, the 3 prime to 5 prime strand of the DNA will be transcribed. But one major difference between DNA and RNA is that in case of DNA, the DNA is having 4 nucleotides: adenine nucleotide, thymine nucleotide, cytosine nucleotide and guanine nucleotide. While in case of RNA, RNA is having 4 nucleotide: adenine nucleotide, uracil nucleotide, cytosine nucleotide and guanine nucleotide. So, you can see there is a big difference in DNA and RNA, the presence of thymine in DNA and the presence of uracil in RNA. So, while writing the template of RNA, you have to think, you have to remember that while writing the RNA, you are not supposed to write thymine nucleotide because thymine is not there in RNA. So, if we start writing the DNA template which has been given in question, A, T, T, C, C, G, T, A, G, G, C, C, T, A, C, C, G. So, this one is your DNA template and this will going to transcribe. So, after transcription, this strand will form the complementary of A will be T, but in case of RNA, thymine is not there. So, we will write U, uracil is there. The complementary of T is A, again A. The complementary of cytosine is guanine. The complementary of guanine is cytosine. The complementary of T is A, and accordingly you can write your sequence. So, this will be your answer. So, this will be your RNA transcript for the given DNA sequence. The next question is, what is the role of sigma factor in transcription? As we learn, with the core enzyme of RNA polymerase, one more factor attached, and that factor is called sigma factor. And that sigma factor helps the RNA polymerase to find the promoter so that the transcription can be initiated. So, without sigma factor, RNA polymerase cannot recognize the promoter of the DNA and cannot initiate the transcription. So, sigma factor is very important factor of the transcription. One more question was there. The question was, what are the differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic transcription? So, the answer of this question we will find in this session. Let us start the session, the transcription process in eukaryotes. Do you know the differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic organism or cells? Yes, you are right. The prokaryotes have a primitive nucleus, they are not having a nuclear membrane. So, the genetic material are scattered in the cytoplasm, while in case of eukaryotes, they have a true nucleus and all the genetic material are enclosed in a nuclear membrane which forms the nucleus. So, because of this differences in the structure of prokaryotes and eukaryotes, there are some differences in the process of transcription in prokaryotes as well as in eukaryotes. So, if we talk about eukaryotic chromosome have nucleosomes. Nucleosomes, yes, you can recall, it is a histone octamer on which the DNA is being wrapped so that the DNA can pack itself inside the nucleus. So, what about these nucleosomes, what about these histone octamers during the transcription? Whether they will interact with the DNA or it will be removed? If it is intact with the DNA, how the transcription will be completed? And if it is being removed, then how the DNA again get wrapped over the histone octamer? And the answer is, these histones octamers are removed by two different enzymes, or we can say protein. One is acetyltransferase enzyme and second one is chromatin remodeling proteins. These acetyltransferase enzyme adds some acetyl group on the histone octamers and destabilize the histone octamers so that the histone will be removed from the DNA and the DNA will be transcribed. And the chromatin remodeling proteins also destabilize the histone octamers. With the help of that, the histone will be removed from the DNA and the DNA will be transcribed. And after transcription, the DNA will again get wrapped itself on the histone octamers. Now, the most important part of transcription is RNA polymerase, the transcription apparatus. In case of prokaryotes, we learn about one RNA polymerase which can transcribe all the type of RNA. In case of prokaryotes, a single RNA polymerase enzyme can transcribe messenger RNA, ribosomal RNA and transfer RNA. But in case of eukaryotes, there are three different RNA polymerase which transcribe all the three different RNA, and these are RNA polymerase 1, which is located in the nucleolus and it catalyzes the synthesis of large ribosomal RNA. So, RNA polymerase 1 helps in the synthesis of ribosomal RNA. RNA polymerase 2, which is located in nucleoplasm and catalyze the synthesis of messenger RNA and small nucleolar RNA. So, basically RNA polymerase 2 helps in the formation of messenger RNA. And the third RNA polymerase is RNA polymerase 3, which is also located in nucleoplasm and it catalyzes the synthesis of transfer RNA and small nuclear RNA. So, you can see one major difference between prokaryotic transcription and eukaryotic transcription. In case of prokaryotes, there is single RNA polymerase which can transcribe all the type of RNAs, but in case of eukaryotes, there are three different RNA polymerases, RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2 and RNA polymerase 3, which can transcribe all the three types of RNA. So, in this session, we will focus on the transcription of messenger RNA. So, transcription of protein coding gene, that part of the DNA which is going to transcribe to form the messenger RNA is called protein coding gene, because that messenger RNA will further participate in protein synthesis, or we can say translation, to synthesize a protein. So, that fragment of the DNA which is going to synthesize messenger RNA is called protein coding gene. So, the transcription of protein coding gene is catalyzed by RNA polymerase 2, which we learned in earlier slide. Eukaryotic gene have a specific promoter, but do not have terminator sequence. Here you can note it down. The second difference between prokaryotic transcription and eukaryotic transcription, the presence of terminator sequence. In case of prokaryotes, they have a specific terminator sequence which helps in termination of transcription, but in case of eukaryotes, there is no any specific terminator sequence to terminate the transcription. And the product of transcription is a precursor messenger RNA. Now, what is this precursor messenger RNA? So, let us understand, in case of eukaryotes, the DNA which is going to transcribe to form the RNA, after transcription, they will form single stranded RNA. If suppose it is a messenger RNA and it is double stranded DNA. So, this double stranded DNA after transcription will form single stranded RNA. Now, this RNA after transcription have a sequence which are arranged alternatively, and these sequences are called exon, intron, exon, intron, exon, and intron, and like so. This E represent exon and I represent intron. Exons are considered as functional part of the DNA, or we can say RNA, and introns are considered as non-functional part of the DNA. So, after transcription of this DNA, whatever RNA is being synthesized is considered as pre-messenger RNA. Pre means precursor, because this pre-messenger RNA is not going to participate in translation because of the presence of these introns, non-functional sequences in the messenger RNA. So, first of all these introns will be removed by the process of processing and splicing, and all exons will get spliced together to form a mature messenger RNA. So, in case of this particular messenger RNA, all the exons will get spliced, and after splicing, the mature messenger RNA will be synthesized. So, I hope it will be clear to you, the pre-messenger RNA and mature messenger RNA. Pre-messenger RNA have the sequences of exon and introns arranged alternatively. Exons are functional part and introns are non-functional part. So, by the process of splicing and processing, these introns will be removed, and all the exons will get spliced together to form mature messenger RNA, and then this mature messenger RNA will participate in protein synthesis to synthesize the protein. The transcription is processed to form mature messenger RNA. So, when in case of eukaryotes, the transcription is completed, the transcript will undergo processing and splicing to form mature messenger RNA. Now, let us talk about promoter of protein coding region. Promoter is a region of DNA where the RNA polymerase bind to initiate the transcription. In case of prokaryotes, if you can recall, in case of prokaryotes, there are two consensus sequences found at minus 10 and minus 35 position. Minus 10 having TAAT consensus sequence and minus 35 is having GACAA sequence as consensus sequence, and these consensus sequences are recognized by RNA polymerase with the help of sigma factor, so that the RNA polymerase initiate the transcription. But in case of eukaryotic transcription, the promoters are somehow different from the prokaryotic DNA. So, promoters are arranged upstream to the transcription initiation site. As I explained in my earlier session, the sequence from where the transcription is going to start is called transcription initiation site or transcription start site. The left sequences, nucleotide sequences to the transcription start site are considered as upstream, and promoters are always found in upstream sequences. And the right sequences, all the sequences to the right of transcription start sites are considered as downstream sequences. Upstream sequences are given negative numbers, while downstream sequences are given positive numbers. So, in case of prokaryotes, in promoter, there are two specific regions are there. One is core promoter and second one is promoter proximal element. So, these two specific regions are found in promoter of eukaryotic DNA. These core promoter and promoter proximal elements are not found in prokaryotic DNA. If we talk about core promoter is characterized by short sequence element called initiator. You can see here in the diagram, the sequence from where the transcription is going to start, here is the initiator, which is given as plus 1, because the transcription will begins from there only. And to the upstream of this initiator, a Tata box is there, which is also known as Goldberg-Hoeganis box. And this Tata box is located at about minus 25 to minus 30 from the transcription start sequence. And promoter proximal element, the second region of the promoter of eukaryotic DNA, it is found to the upstream of Tata box. You can see this is the Tata box TATAAA. This is Tata box, which is found in core promoter, and to the upstream of this core promoter, promoter proximal element is there, which have two specific consensus sequence. One is CAAT, which is also known as cat box, which is located about minus 80 sequence from the transcription start site, and another consensus sequence is GC sequence, which is also known as GC box, which is located at about minus 100 from the transcription start site. So, this is the way how we can recognize, and even the how the RNA polymerase recognize the promoter of the eukaryotic DNA. So, the eukaryotic DNA having two specific region in their promoter, one is core promoter and another is promoter proximal element. In core promoter, there is Tata box, and in promoter proximal element, there is cat box and GC box. Now, let's know about how the transcription initiate. If you can recall the transcription initiation of prokaryotes, there is no any requirement of transcriptional factors. But in case of eukaryotic transcription, there is a requirement of general transcription factors. In case of prokaryotes, RNA polymerase can do all the works, but here RNA polymerase takes the help of these general transcription factors to initiate the transcription. And RNA polymerase, along with these general transcription factors, assemble over the core promoter. First, the transcription factor 2D binds to Tata box to form initial committed complex. After the binding of TF2, TF2 means transcription factor 2, D binds to Tata box. This Tata box 2D factor having two different protein or two different factors, one is TBA, that is Tata binding protein, and another is TAF, that is TBP associated factors. So, transcription factor 2D have two different subunits. One is Tata binding protein, that is TBA, and second one is Tata binding protein associated factor, that is TAF. This TBA, Tata binding protein, helps the RNA polymerase to recognize the Tata box. So, in continuation to that, after the binding of TF2D over the Tata box, transcription factor 2A and transcription factor 2B binds to this initial committed complex, which is followed by transcription factor 2F and RNA polymerase 2. As I told you earlier, RNA polymerase 2 helps in the transcription of protein coding gene, which will transcribe to form messenger RNA. So, TF2A and TF2B will binds over the initial committed complex, and after their binding, that will be followed by transcription factor 2F and RNA polymerase 2. And when they bind over those complex, they will form minimal transcription initiation complex. So, after the formation of minimal transcription initiation complex, transcription factor 2E and transcription factor 2H binds to produce complete initiation complex, which is also called as pre-initiation complex. And now, from here, the transcription will begin. So, you can see there are so many transcription factors involved in the initiation of the transcription in eukaryotes. These transcription factors are not there in prokaryotic transcription. So, it is also another difference between prokaryotic and eukaryotic transcription. So, this you can see in this diagram. So, this particular DNA is going to transcribe to form messenger RNA, that is why this DNA is called protein coding gene. The transcription will start at a particular point, and that point is called transcription start point. All the sequences, nucleotide sequences, which are present in the left of this transcription start site is called upstream sequences, and all the right sequences are called downstream sequences. And to this transcription start point, there is a promoter to the upstream of this transcription start site, and at this promoter there are two different regions, core promoter and promoter proximal element. Or at the core promoter, transcription factor 2D, which have two different subunits TAF and TBP. TAF is transcription binding protein associated factors, and TBP is Tata binding protein. Now, this transcription factor 2D will bind over the core promoter after recognizing the Tata box. After their binding, transcription factor 2A and transfection factor 2B will bind over those complex, and this will be followed by the binding of transcription factor 2F and RNA polymerase 2. When these two will bind over the complex, they will form minimal transcription initiation complex, and after this minimal transcription initiation complex, transcription factor 2E and transcription factor 2H will bind over the complex and they will form pre-initiation complex. Now, from here the transcription will begin, and the elongation is somehow similar to the bacterial transcription. Now, structure of mature messenger RNA. After the transcription, if we talk about mature messenger RNA, it means there is no any introns, there is no any non-functional sequence. So, an active messenger RNA have three main parts. One is 5 prime untranslated region, which is also called ladder sequence. Second one is protein coding sequence, which will codes for the protein. And third one is 3 prime untranslated region, which is also called as trailer sequence. This is the structure of an active messenger RNA, or we can say mature messenger RNA. Now, how the mature messenger RNA is being produced? If we talk about transcription, in case of eukaryotes, after transcription, pre-messenger RNA is being synthesized, which is having introns as well as exons. Now, how these introns are being removed and how the exons are spliced to form mature messenger RNA? So, the production of mature messenger RNA includes 5 prime modification, which is known as capping. Second one is 3 prime modification, which is called as poly A tailing, and third one is processing of pre-messenger RNA, that is removal of introns and splicing of exons. So, these three processes will take participate to form mature messenger RNA. So, let us talk about 5 prime modification, that is capping. So, capping is initiated with the help of an enzyme which is called capping enzyme, which adds a guanine nucleotide called 7-methyl guanosine to the 5 end. If you can recall, the two nucleotides are being joined together with the help of phosphodiester bond. The first nucleotides, the 3 end will participate in the bond formation with the 5 end of the second nucleotide. So, there is always 3 prime to 5 prime phosphodiester linkage in all the nucleotides. But in case of capping, there is unusual 5 prime to 5 prime linkage. That means, 7-methyl guanosine is having 3 prime as well as 5 prime end. Usually, the 3 prime participate in the bond formation, but in case of capping, the 5 prime end of the 7-methyl guanosine will form the bond with 5 prime end of the growing RNA sequences. So, they will form an unusual 5 prime to 5 prime linkage, which will form the cap, and the sugar of the next two nucleotides are also get modified with the help of some methyl transferase enzyme, which will add the methyl group and they modify the nucleotides. So, this is how the capping is being done at the 5 end of the synthesized RNA transcript. So, you can see this is a particular RNA sequence which is going to transcribed. So, at this nucleotide, this 7-methyl guanosine, the 5 prime end will form the phosphodiester bond with the 5 prime of the growing nucleotide at the 5 end, and they will form 5 prime unusual bond, and this will lead to the capping. So, there is a specific function of this 5 prime capping. Do you know what? Yes, of course. This 5 prime capping helps in the initiation of translation, as there is no any particular sequence for the ribosome to initiate the translation. So, ribosome recognize this 5 prime capping and initiate the translation. This we will learn in the translation session. So, this 5 prime capping helps in the initiation of translation. It also helps in increasing the stability of messenger RNA. As messenger RNA very much unstable biomolecule in the cell, so this 5 prime capping also increases the stability of the messenger RNA, and it prevents the messenger RNA from the degradation of by the different nuclease enzymes. And it also influences the removal of introns. How the introns are being removed, in the removal of that introns, this 5 prime capping helps. Now, let us know about 3 prime modification. 3 prime modification is the addition of 50 to 250 adenine nucleotide at 3 prime end, which is also called as poly A tail. So, if we distinguish the messenger RNA of eukaryotes and the messenger RNA of prokaryotes, there is no any 5 prime cap and 3 prime poly A tail in the messenger RNA of prokaryotes. But in case of eukaryotic messenger RNA, they have 5 prime cap and 3 prime poly A tail. Now, how this poly A tail is being added up to the messenger RNA? This poly A tail includes many enzymes or protein, and these are cleavase and polyadenylation specificity factor, that is CPSF. Second one is cleavage stimulation factor, that is CSTF, and it also includes 2 cleavage factors, that is CF1 and CF2, and it also take the help of polyadenylate polymerase enzyme, that is PAP. So, these factors, these proteins help in 3 prime poly A tail formation. These factors are cleavage and polyadenylation specificity factor, that is CPSF, cleavage stimulation factor, that is CSTF, 2 cleavage factors protein CF1 and CF2, and polyadenylate polymerase PAP enzyme. These CPSF and CSTF, along with cleavage factor 1 and 2, binds to poly A site and cleave the RNA. So, you can see in the diagram, so this is the transcription, these are the transcription process, and this is the RNA which has been already synthesized. So, after the formation of complete set of RNA transcript, this CPSF, that is cleavage and polyadenylation specificity factor, and this CSTF, that is cleavage stimulation factors, they join together at poly A site, and the 2 cleavage factors CF1 and CF2 also attach to the RNA transcript and cleave the sequences. You can see over here, this is the cleaved part. Here it is a 5 prime end and here it is a 3 prime end. Now, this RNA is considered as pre-messenger RNA, and now this pre-messenger RNA will undergo 5 prime capping and 3 prime poly A tail formation. Now, how the poly A tail is being synthesized? You can see after the cleavage, by the cleavage factor 1 and 2, the 2 another protein PAP, that is poly A polymerase, and PAB2, that is poly A binding proteins, they combines together and they will add adenine nucleotides to the 3 prime end, It may be 50 to 250 long with the help of adenosine triphosphate. So, this is how the 3 prime poly A tail is being added up with the help of poly A polymerase enzyme and poly A binding proteins. You can see in the diagram. So, enzyme PAP bounds to CPS F add adenine nucleotide to 3 prime end using ATP. So, this ATP will be used as precursor for poly A tail. While adding up the adenine nucleotide will give it 2 phosphate for the bond formation, and only AMP will be added up to form the poly A tail. Now, very important section of eukaryotic transcription, that is processing of pre-messenger RNA to mature RNA. Processing means how the introns are removed and how the exons are added up to form mature messenger RNA. So, introns, that is intervening sequences, are non-functional sequences, and exons, that is expressing, are functional sequences present alternatively in pre-messenger RNA. So, which I already told you earlier, in case of eukaryotes, after transcription, the pre-messenger RNA is being synthesized, if we talk about protein coding gene, and these pre-messenger RNA have the sequences of introns, that is intervening sequences, which are non-functional sequences, and exons, which are expressing or functional sequences, arranged alternatively in the sequences. These introns are removed from pre-messenger RNA and exons are joined by messenger RNA splicing. So, all the introns of pre-messenger RNA will be removed one by one and all the exons will be joined to form mature messenger RNA. Introns are recognized by the presence of certain sequence. If we talk about beginning of introns, introns always begin with 5 prime GU sequence. For any particular pre-messenger RNA, the introns are always begin with the sequence at its 5 prime end, that is GU sequence, and that introns always end with AG sequence. That means, at the end of the introns, adenine and guanine nucleotide is there, and at the 5 prime end, guanine and uracil sequence is there. So, this is the way how the introns can be recognized. At the beginning, at the 5 prime end, there is GU sequence, and at the end, there is AG sequence. Splicing occur in spliceosomes. Splicing means removal of introns and addition of all the exons. So, it is occurs with the help of spliceosomes. Spliceosomes is a complex of the pre-messenger RNA, bounds to a small nuclear ribonucleoprotein, which is also called as snRNPs. So, when pre-messenger RNA combines with a small nuclear ribonucleoproteins, they will form a complex which is called as spliceosomes. There are 5 principal snRNP, that is a small nuclear ribonucleoprotein, and these are U1, U2, U4, U5 and U6. These 5 principal small nuclear ribonucleoprotein helps in processing and splicing of pre-messenger RNA. Now, let us see the steps of processing of pre-messenger RNA. The first, the ribonucleoprotein U1 will binds to the 5 prime junction. Secondly, the U2 small nuclear RNP will binds to branch point sequences, which is towards the 3 prime end. just upstream to the 3 prime end. Next, U4 and U6 ribonucleoprotein together interact with U5 small nuclear ribonucleoprotein, and all these 3 ribonucleoprotein will bind over the U1 and U2 small nuclear ribonucleoprotein, which cause the introns to make the loop. This you can see in the diagram. Let us suppose this is a pre-RNA, pre-messenger RNA. Here is the exon 1 and here is the exon 2, and in between these exons there is a sequence which is called introns. Introns are non-functional sequences, which is also called intervening sequences, and exons are functional sequences, which are also called as expressing sequences. So, if we talk about introns, in the 5 prime end, the introns have GU end, and at the 3 prime end, the introns have AG sequence. So, this is how we can recognize the introns, and to the upstream of this AG, there is a branch point at adenine nucleotide. So, first of all, this U1 small nuclear RNP will bind over the GU sequence at the 5 prime. After the binding of U1 small nuclear RNP, the U2 will bind over the branch point. It will not bind at the 3 prime, it will bind over the branch point. Now, after the binding of this U1 and U2 small nuclear RNP, the U4 and U6 will combine together, and this complex will again interact with U5 small nuclear RNP, and all these 3 will bind over the introns and they will form a loop of the intron. You can see the loop. Now, from here the U4 will be released. After the release, after the dissociation of this U4 small nuclear ribonucleoprotein, there is the formation of active spliceosome. This particular structure is called active spliceosome. A spliceosome is the combination of pre-messenger RNA and a small nuclear ribonucleoprotein. Now, from this active spliceosome, these 2 exons will splice together, exon 1 and exon 2, and the remaining introns along with a small nuclear RNP having the lariat shape will be removed. And then again from this lariat shaped intron, all the small nuclear RNP will be removed and the introns will also get separated out. So, this is how all the introns one by one will be removed with the help of a small nuclear ribonucleoprotein. So, U4 SNP RNP dissociates, resulting in formation of active spliceosome. You can see after the binding of all the small nuclear ribonucleoprotein, there are 5 small nuclear RNP protein. One is U1, U2, U4, U6 and U5. All these 5 principal small nuclear ribonucleoprotein will bind over the introns. After the binding, this E4 will be removed. A spliceosome cleaves the introns from exon 1 at the 5 prime splice junction. Now, this active spliceosome will cleave this introns at 5 prime end, and a spliceosome excises the introns by cleaving it at 3 prime junction and the ligates exon 1 and exon 2 together. And the same spliceosome will remove this introns by cleaving at the 3 prime end, so that the exon 1 and exon 2 will be spliced together to form mature messenger RNA. So, let us think over this question. Before thinking over this question, let us answer the question which I asked in my earlier session. What are the differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic transcription? So, if you can see, there are so many differences. Although the process of transcription is very much similar in prokaryotes and eukaryotes, but there are some dim similarity, there are some differences also, and these differences we can point over here. So, differences between prokaryotic transcription and eukaryotic transcription. Few of the differences we have learned in the session. The first is about the RNA polymerase. In case of prokaryotes, there is just one type of RNA polymerase which can transcribe all the three type of RNA: transfer RNA, messenger RNA and ribosomal RNA. There is a single RNA polymerase which can transcribe all the three type of RNA. While in case of eukaryotic transcription, there are three types of RNA polymerase: RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2 and RNA polymerase 3. RNA polymerase transcribe ribosomal RNA, 2 transcribe messenger RNA and RNA polymerase 3 transcribe transfer RNA. So, it is the first difference between prokaryotic and eukaryotic transcription. The enzyme RNA polymerase, there is a single RNA polymerase which can transcribe all the three type of RNA in case of prokaryotes, while in case of eukaryotes, there are three different RNA polymerase: polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2 and RNA polymerase 3, which will transcribe the three different RNAs. Now, we talk about the subunits of RNA polymerase. If you can recall, the prokaryotic RNA polymerase have four subunits: two of alpha, one of beta, one of beta prime, and this will join together to form four subunits along with sigma factor. So, basically there are four subunits in case of RNA polymerase of prokaryotic transcription, but in case of eukaryotic RNA polymerase, it is very much complex RNA polymerase, means they have more than four subunit in their structure. Next, about the promoter. So, if we talk about the promoter of the prokaryotic DNA, the promoter is having two consensus sequences. Do you know what is this consensus sequences? Yes, consensus sequences are those sequences which are being repeated again and again at the same position, at the same point in most of the living organism. So, in the promoter of the prokaryotes, there are two consensus sequences. One is at minus 10 and another is at minus 35. At minus 10, there is TA, TAA, T consensus sequence, while at minus 35, there is TT, GA, CA consensus sequence. While in case of eukaryotes, eukaryotes have two different promoter sequence. One is core promoter, it have Tata box, and another is proximal promoter element, which have two consensus sequence, that is CAAT box, which is also known as CAD box, and GC box. So, the promoter have different consensus sequences in the prokaryotes as well as in eukaryotes. So, if we talk about some more differences in prokaryotic transcription and eukaryotic transcription. The prokaryotic DNA is polycistronic, while eukaryotic DNA is monocistronic. Now, what is the meaning of polycistronic and monocistronic? Polycistronic means for certain biochemical reaction, whatever enzymes are being synthesized by the genes, they all are arranged together, they are not separated. So, once the transcription is being started, all the three genes or whatever the gene number of genes are there will be transcribed simultaneously. While in case of eukaryotes, the genes are present at a distance, they are not present together. That is why the prokaryotic DNA is polycistronic, while eukaryotic DNA is monocistronic. And if we talk about termination, if you can recall, in case of prokaryotes, there are two types of termination: rho dependent and rho independent. It means there are particular sequence of termination in the prokaryotic DNA which will give the signal for the termination of transcription, either with the help of rho factor or without the help of rho factor. So, there is a presence of a particular sequence which will help in the termination of the transcription in prokaryotes, but such type of terminator sequences are not there in eukaryotes. So, in case of eukaryotes, the transcription is being terminated with the help of 5 prime modification, that is capping, 3 prime poly A tail formation and processing and splicing. These three different stages, these three different processes will help in the termination of the transcription in eukaryotes. If we talk about messenger RNA, in prokaryotes, after transcription, mature messenger RNA is being synthesized, but in case of eukaryotes, after transcription, pre-messenger RNA is being synthesized. Pre means precursor messenger RNA, which will undergo processing and splicing to form mature messenger RNA. So, this processing and splicing is not there in messenger RNA. So, messenger RNA have all their sequences functional in case of prokaryotes, while in case of eukaryotes, the messenger RNA synthesized after transcription are arranged as exons, intron, exon, introns, and this introns is being removed and exons are being spliced to form mature messenger RNA. So, I hope the differences in prokaryotic and eukaryotic transcription will be clear to you. Now, let us think over this question. The first, what are introns and exons? This question is very much easy for you. Just think over this question and I will give the answer in my coming session. Second question, what are the functions of cap? Cap, which is there in eukaryotic messenger RNA at 5 prime end, what is the function of that cap in the messenger RNA? And what do you mean by processing and splicing? This processing and splicing occurs only in eukaryotes, not in prokaryotes. So, what is this processing and splicing? So, thank you very much. We will meet you again with the answer of this question in my next session. Thank you.